Hello, and welcome to this lesson on the dot product. Now, before we talk about what the dot product is, let's talk about why we care about knowing the dot product at all. So up until now, we've had a standard form for describing our vectors. So a vector v, and we describe them in terms of the standard axes, the x, the y, the z. So vector v has component vx times the unit vector a sub x plus a y component v sub y times the unit vector a sub y, and a z component times the unit vector in terms of c. Excuse me, not c, z. So right now, we're used to describing our vectors in terms of these standard unit vectors. But what if we had a unit vector in some weird, crazy direction? How could we describe v in terms of that random unit vector? That's where the dot product comes in. So let's jump in. Imagine that we have two vectors. Let's call this first one vector A, and this next one, let's call it vector B. The dot product basically says, what is the component of B in the direction of A? So this entire component there would be B dot product A. We want to know the length of that component right there. We can also use the fact that we can find the angle between them, so we'll call it the angle B of A, between these guys, it helps us find the dot product as well. Now, there are a number of different formulas that let us calculate the dot product. The first one is called its geometric representation. So that just says that B dot A is equal to the magnitude of B times the magnitude of A times the cosine of the angle between them, the angle BA. Now that's pretty good, but that requires us to calculate the magnitudes and know the angle between them. A simpler formula for calculating the dot product is B dot A is equal to just the sums of the components multiplied together. So BX times AX plus BY times AY plus BZ times AZ, just like that. Now there are a few other properties. For example, if we have vector A, if we have a vector that's dotted with itself, we get just the magnitude of the vector squared. And if we take the dot product of a vector times a unit vector, well then that's just going to be equal to the magnitude of the vector times the cosine of the angle between the vector and the unit vector. All that says there is that that magnitude of the unit vector, as we already know, is equal to 1. So when we talk about the components of a vector, there are two components, the scalar component and the vector component. The scalar component is just the dot product. So if I want to know the scalar component of, let's say, vector g in the direction of some unit vector, a sub n, that's just equal to the dot product of g and a n. That's the scalar component. Now, if I want to know the vector component, well, this is the magnitude. The vector component just tells me the direction. So that's just equal to the dot product, which is the magnitude of that vector, times the unit vector itself. So those are the two big things that the unit vector gets us. It gets us a way to represent our vector in terms of other vectors, and we can find these scalar and vector components. So let's go ahead and work an example. We're given two things. First, we have a vector field. We'll call that g is a function of r and is equal to y times the unit vector a sub x minus 2.5 times x times the unit vector a sub y plus 3 times the unit vector a sub z. We're given that vector field and we're given a point q at 4, 5, and 2. And from that, we want to find the following things. First, find the vector g of r evaluated at point q. Once we have that, I want to know the scalar component of g of r of q in the direction of this unit vector, a of n, which is equal to 1/3 2 times the unit vector a sub x plus the unit vector a sub y minus 2 times the unit vector a sub z. Once I have that, I want to know the vector component of g in the direction of a sub n. And finally, I want to know the angle between g and a sub n. So I want to find these four things. Let's do part one first. G of r is equal to the following expression. Y times a of x plus 2.5x times a of y. That should be minus 2.5 plus 3 times a of z, and q is at 0.452. Then the vector at that point, so g r of q, is going to be equal to 5 times the unit vector a sub x minus 2.5 times 4 times the unit vector a sub y plus 3 times the unit vector a sub z. Simplify that slightly, gets us 5ax minus 10 ay plus 3 az. So there we go. There's our first vector. Now, in part two, I want to know the scalar component of g in the direction of a sub n. So I want to find g of r of q dotted with a sub n. So that's just going to be our vector up here. 5 a of x minus 10 a of y plus 3 a of z dotted with 1/3 2ax plus ay minus 2 az. Now what we'll get is 1/3 times the dot product of these two vectors, 5ax minus 10 ay plus 3az dotted with 2ax plus ay minus 2az gets us 1/3 times 5 times 2 plus negative 10 times 1 plus 3 times 2. And that's going to equal 1/3 times 10 minus 10 plus 6 is going to equal 6 over 3. Oh, and I lost a negative somewhere. Yeah, that should have been times negative 2, which makes that minus 6. Makes that minus 6 over 3, which means that's minus 2. So the scalar component of g of r of q in the direction of unit vector a sub n is equal to negative 2. Now, part 3, to find the vector component, remember, is just g of r of q dotted with a sub n, the scalar component, times a sub n. So that's just going to be equal to negative 2 times 1/3 times 2ax plus ay minus 2az. Simplifying that gets us minus 2/3 times the vector 2ax plus ay minus 2az z. 2/3 distributes and gets us minus 4/3 ax minus 2/3 ay plus 4/3 az. And if we evaluate those fractions, we get minus 1.33 ax minus 0.67 ay plus 1.33 az. And there we go. There's our vector component of g in the direction of a sub n, right? Now it's described in terms of x, y, and z. And finally, last thing we need to find is the angle between these two vectors, the angle of g and a. Of g and a n is equal to, here we use that cosine formula, magnitude of g times magnitude of a sub n times the cosine of g a, of theta g a. Let's see, we know that the dot product, the scalar component there, is negative 2. We need to find the magnitude of g. Let's go ahead and do that over here in a different color. Let's say, so the magnitude of g is equal to the square root of 5 squared plus negative 10 squared plus 3 squared equals the square root of 25 plus 100 plus 9 equals the square root of 134. So that means it's equal to the square root of 134 times 1, right? Remember, that's the unit vector, so its magnitude is 1, times the cosine of theta g a. And all that's left is a little bit of algebra, so we get that minus 2 over square root of 134 is equal to cosine of theta ga. Theta sub ga is equal to the inverse cosine of negative 2 over square root of 134. If we punch that in our calculator, we get that it's equal to 99.9 degrees. There we go. That's all about the dot product. The dot product tells us the components of a vector in the direction of any arbitrary vector, right? So now we're not limited to just vectors in terms of x, y, and z. And we worked out an example of given a vector field and a point. We found a vector, found the scalar component in the direction of an arbitrary unit vector, found its vector component, and then calculated the angle between those two vectors. As always, if you have any questions, please let me know, and I will see you in the next lesson. Thank you.